Doesn't even look like it's worth putting any makeup on. It's raining. It's snowing a bit earlier, but it's obviously all just melted now. There's my car. Getting rained on. Oh, it looks miserable.
Anyway, so I thought in this video I'd talk about the bad stuff about bodybuilding, especially for women in general, and hopefully not take too long so that I've got time to do a few pictures. So you can't see anything, I'm just going to get my makeup on. Oh no, it's going everywhere. Yeah, I do have actual boxes to put my makeup in, but I prefer to just chuck it all in here and then just like empty it when I need it. Because I'm just lazy. But yeah. So first I like to do my eyes don't have to get. And everything's upside down. Yeah. So when I first got into bodybuilding, it all looks very appealing, doesn't it? And I just think, oh, she's coming. I can hear her. Hi, Annabelle.
Morning.
You okay?
I don't want to continue.
I've already missed two lectures.
Have you? I've missed one.
I'm filming, by the way.
Are you filming? Oh, shit.
I just thought I'd warn you.
It's okay, I'm wearing my towel. I'll leave you to it.
No, no, come in and talk for a bit.
Are you pausing it, or...?
I'm doing really chilled out video.
Okay.
I was just about to talk about what's bad about bodybuilding.
Oh, what isn't bad about bodybuilding? speaking of bodybuilding.
Yeah.
I'll show the camera what I was listening to.
Oh yeah, I like that picture.
It has a female bodybuilder on it.
I commented asking who it was, didn't I?
They didn't reply.
And they never replied to me, oh well.
Fame has got to them.
Fame has got to them.
No, I'm joking. They probably didn't see it.
Yes, and I'll be using my favourite palette, the androgyny palette. Now, this isn't a makeup tutorial, it's just joking.
I'm happy just watching.
I've already missed two lectures because my alarm clock didn't work.
Yeah, mine didn't. That's why I missed mine as well. My alarm wasn't loud enough.
So I'm using a naked heat palette, if anyone's interested. Just in case. It's very nice. Yeah, so as I was saying, you get into bodybuilding, and it all looks really good. And then you decide, right, I'll start putting on muscle. And then you gain weight. And that shouldn't be such a shock. Like... I shouldn't even be needing to say it, but like you're actually like, oh shit, like you sort of like, it's a really big step, like, but especially when you're a girl and you've always thought, like, everyone's always said to you, you need to be skinny, and then you actually want to gain weight and you do, and it's just really different, and it's like When I started putting on like muscle, like I really did like it, and I really sort of thought, oh, this is really cool, getting bigger. And then like looking back on the pictures now, I got like really big, and like I don't know if I'd want to get that big again. Like, no, not like muscle wise. I do want to get bigger muscle wise, but I was quite like chubby as well, and I was like, well, but you sort of, I don't know, it's just my body, like it just puts on fat quite easily, so sort of just need to do it and just like get over it. But it can be quite hard, definitely. It's a big deal for girls. And then after that point, I sort of really wanted to diet, obviously, because I wanted to compete. I've tried competing twice. The first time I didn't because I was still too fat, basically. Which is fair enough, I was like, I'll do it next year. And then the next year I would have probably done it, but then my competition was cancelled and it was really hard because I needed to do that one at that time because I was going on holiday. And so when that was cancelled, I could only do it after my holiday, and I was going on 3 weeks to America. I was like, I'm not dieting like this, it was like a proper once in a lifetime trip to America. I was like, I'm not dieting when I'm in America, screw that. I mean, I didn't go crazy in America or anything, but I didn't want to worry about food, I didn't want to worry about like working out and stuff and getting cardio in, because you don't do a lot of cardio in America. So, maybe I could have if I tried a bit harder, but I had like exams and stuff, and yeah, so I thought, so this is the year, like this next year is probably the year if I want to compete. I still don't think I'm big enough though. Like, I don't know, I'm always like a little bit behind. They just keep getting bigger and bigger and I'm always staying behind. I'm like, oh, I can't compete. Whereas like, you know, I don't think I'm really that big. I don't know, because I haven't been on stage. So, but yeah. My plans at the moment, I'm on a bulk at the moment. And it's going okay. Like, that's why I don't really take many pictures, because like bulking is just like when you cut, you can see changes a bit more. But there is a bit more pressure when you're cutting to actually sort of show changes, because otherwise you look like you just haven't been dieting and you haven't been trying. But like, I mean, with a bulk, you're just getting fat basically. Like, I am putting on muscles on my arms, I can tell. But like, it's just like there's just like a layer of fat that just comes in straight away, and you just like can't see anything, and you just look shit. So, but I just usually when I'm on a bulk, try to get creative with poses. I try to like do some like fun sort of shoots so that I can post some pictures, so that I don't just leave it off Instagram. I don't do Instagram for like the likes and stuff and for followers and stuff. Like, it's always just been somewhere where I put my pictures, and people, like, I like seeing all the comments and stuff, and that people enjoying seeing my pictures. But I mean, if I'm too busy, I will just leave it, and just I don't mind if people sort of stop following me and stuff. I will get back to it eventually, so. Because like, I'll never stop bodybuilding. I won't be one of those who like sort of like gives up on bodybuilding. A lot of girls get into bodybuilding and they put on like muscle and stuff, and they like that because they get to eat what they want. And then they actually do a show and they have to diet, and dieting's so shit. Like, it is actually just shit. It's not, there's nothing good about it. It's just shit. And then they're like, but they do it, and they persevere. They don't just think, oh, fuck it. And then they do a show, and then they do it, and then they maybe win it or come second, or they usually do quite well in it because they push themselves so hard, and then there'll be the post-show talk, the post-show binge, and then they'll be like, I'm never competing ever again, I'd rather have pizza and be lazy and stuff, which is fair enough. Like, I think bodybuilding is such an extreme sport, and they try to market it to like everyone. There'll never be a sport for everyone. You've got to be like odd, and you've got to like it and stuff. And I think what's appealing to everyone is getting a nice body. But I mean, and then they go like competing is not healthy, I'll tell you a secret, it's not healthy. No, it's a fucking course, it's not healthy, like, everyone knows that. It's like, but which sport is healthy? Like, extreme sports aren't healthy, like, they're meant to push you, like, to places that aren't really places that people want to be and stuff, like, to win. It's just the whole point. Yeah, and then obviously, like, when you're changing, everyone else sees that you're changing. And so, like, basically, like, my family members weren't very happy about it. And, you know, I didn't really put me off doing stuff, but, like, I had my dad saying, like, oh, you're getting, like, jowls and stuff. And he's like, are you wanting to be a man? I was just like, well, no. I was like, right, does muscles mean that I want a sex change? Like, it was really hurtful to hear him say that, because I don't know, she just wasn't very nice about it. Yeah, I think that looks quite nice.
I thought my mum was quite supportive. Like, she seemed quite supportive. But then, like, early this year, I went to my granddad's funeral. And I was wearing, like, a blazer and a skirt that covered my thighs. And so I looked normal, like it covered all my muscles, and I just looked really normal. And then my granddad, like my other granddad, obviously, like looked at me and was just like, "Oh, have you gone back to normal now?" And then like my mum was like, "Oh no, she's still doing it and stuff," but like in the really like, oh yeah, like really judgy way. I was just like, "Oh, for fuck's sake!" Like my whole family's against me. It's really shit. Like it literally feels like everyone's against you, and it's just like, oh. Is it worth it? But obviously it is. Fuck the way I feel right now. I'll never feel this anymore. Shut the feelings all right down. I'll never need them. Now till all sublime. Forever. It's just some useless word you say. You threw it all away. Didn't you? I'll ever hope you someday feel this ache. You threw it. It's real until it's everything I want it to be. I'll never fall again. No. Forever. It's just some useless word.
I don't know what sport. And Tio are just adjusting the new, what are they called?
Straps.
Straps. I thought it had a more technical name.
I think it's like lifting straps.
Dad bodybuilder jargon.
These are my thumbs after this.
Oh, DOMS, I know that. What was it?
Daily onset muscle soreness.
Yeah. Daily onset muscle soreness, that is. DOMS, DOMS. Maybe one time. And it messes with my OCD. Dat ass. Give it a wiggle.
My hair falls on my back under no circumstances moving, right?
Why?
Because it just looks really weird when you...
Oh, it does look weird. But keep it out the way.
I'm trying.
Yeah, split it in half.
My legs on my hair.
Dirty bitch.